Welcome to Magic Gathering Strat. I'm Dan. I'm going to play a game against Emmerich. He's going to play Affinity. I'm going to play White Weenie. I'm playing White Weenie because White Weenie needs to be in the Pauper Gauntlet. What is the Pauper Gauntlet, you ask me? I will tell you later. Or you might find some information on this YouTube channel. I'm going to keep this. It's not a very good hand. We just played the match, exactly this matchup, and Emmerich won, but I did such a horrible mistake in the last duel that I actually censored the whole match. And I very seldom do that. You've seen me done horrible, horrible mistakes. But this one was perhaps the worst I ever made. So I didn't want to waste your time showing you this. We did the match again. So now I need to focus. My plan here is to cast the Skyfisher. Okay, new plan. My plan now is to cast the Loyal Cathar so I can keep that Frogmite in check. And the best thing would be if he actually attacked so I can Skyfisher the undead Cathar. But he'll probably not do that, as he has that thing. But now Bone Splitter is showing itself from its best side. And I will be able to equip and then force a trade here that he don't want. Now all my crap creatures can trade with his powerful creatures, which is the power of Bone Splitter. So how does he solve this? It probably involves killing the Cathar, and that means I can then get the Cathar back with the other Skyfisher. And actually Vigilance here is really, really good for us. Okay, I'm gonna cast the other Skyfisher, and the Cathar will be around to block, so we can just swing here. He might trade the Hour Guard for the Cathar. No, but of course he does that trade. So I'm getting him to 12, casting the Skyfisher, returning the planes, playing the Bone Splitter. And that's all my business. I think he's gonna Galvanic Blast here. And he does it on the Cathar. And now I have no defense against the Kerberos Forger. On the other hand, I have 2-turn clock on him. But if you can kill the Skyfisher, I have flooded and I'm dead. And it is not unlikely. So how much damage from this guy? Oh, it's lethal, isn't it? Sure it is. War Falcon is gonna block. What could possibly go wrong with that plan? Eating one artifact from Aatrox here could be really decisive. Tell me, do I want Prismatic Strand against the Aatrox Fling combo? Do I not want it? I'm not sure. I'm bringing in 4 Dust Rust and 1 Prismatic Strand, but not both in my sideboard. For One Knight of Circe and four Javelineers. I'm blocking the ATOG. Oh, we had a fling. That's actually exactly the way the first match ended last time. I think he forgot about the Carapace Forger there. Okay, so bring in the four Dust to Dust. And one Prismatic Strands, taking out the Kaithian Javelineers as he does not have the Disciples. I fiddle around with Mana Tithe and stuff, but it's just not very useful against anything. I'm not a fan of Mana Tithe, I'm not a fan of Daze, I'm not a fan of Forespike. Conditional counterspells you get stuck with. Not what I want to do in my aggressive decks. Okay, these Falcons will not be able to attack, so I need to get to the Guardian, so I'm gonna play the step first. Yeah, the secluded steps don't feels like a non-bow with Razor Golem. But I'm using a deck that actually got a result, one of the few white winnie decks to do so in a thousand years, it feels like. It was Kult that accomplished this feat. Oh, I can't even cast Razor Golem for 3. And my Falcons looks very stupid. But he can do nothing about Guardian of the Guild Pact, except block it with Enforcers, of course. Prismatic Strands. And they don't have color. So is this really a good card to have in the deck? To bring in this matchup? This is just the Frogmites and the Forcers. I don't know. Oh, there's something I can Prismatic Strands. Guardian of the Guild Pact. Wish he was a soldier. With that enormous mistake in my last match against Emmerich, I'm now 1-3 with White Ween in practice. So that's not very impressive, and it actually makes it the worst on my decks. What's going on? He's casting a Carapace Forger. but I'm no longer afraid of them. Still no soldier. Taking out the javelineers created this problem, didn't it? So it's probably not what I take out for my dusty dust. So what do I take out? Let me know what you want me to sideboard against Affinity. Guardian's Pledge. Not too interesting here. Just the soldiers, I can start attacking. Let's do it. But he can double block with the Frogmites. What a stalemate. Skyfisher, what do I want? What do I really want? I want the step. To return it. I'm gonna use the Guardian's Pledge here. And then swing with these guys. Maybe that was way too aggressive. Do I want to kill one of them? No. Just let me untap before you Atog fling me. Damn. Cycle that. Journey to Nowhere. No, it's just the Sky Hunter. Unequip here. And Prismatic Strand felt very counterproductive. It felt like I was... I wanted to sit back and use it a lot of the time, but then I wanted to attack, so I couldn't use it. I'm gonna block one of the Forgers with the Guardian and another with both the others. Flood was just too massive. Ah, okay. Yeah. Look at the amount of lands he has. That was quite huge. But that is very much Affinity. So what about the War Falcons? Ah, I'm keeping this as is. See if I can win a match here to make my awesome White Windy deck into a 2-5 deck. Actually, the first matches were not played. I have Suture Priest still in the deck. Yeah, because I took out the Knight of Cersei. Yeah, I'm gonna keep this. Looks well. Guardian of the Guild Pact, he really has no way of dealing with it, it seems. So that was very useful, especially with Bone Splitter. Imagine, actually, I actually took out Guardian of Gilpact in the first match we played. But here I have a nice curve. If I draw just one land, going Suture Priest, raise a Golem, Guardian will feel good enough. Yeah, no 4-4 on turn 2. It's fantastic. There is my land. One Suture Priest feels very random, but I like the guy. If he doesn't play 4-4 here, but he will. He has one 4-4, he has 8 in the deck, there is. Yes. So how do I protect myself against that guy? Well, I'll just survive until next turn, and then everything will be swell with the Guardians. Always yes, always yield. Yes. Well, the Enforcer, I really have no answer to them, do I? Except on my 4 Dust to Dust that I will now top deck. Ooh. That hurt. And the flashback will hurt too. Wow. I am so dead here. And that's affinity for you. It just gets these fantastic starts. And I'm now 1-4 with my white weenie deck. 1-2 again, exactly the same result as last time, but this time I defended myself better. But 1-4 is pretty bad. 20% win percentage. I'm not that low with any other deck. I think I am dead this turn. No surprise there. Do I block a 4-4 with the Suture Priest to kill the Frogmite? I think I am doing that. So I only go to 6. But then what? Now I pretty much need the Dust to Dust. And some time. But I can draw 2 cards for a Dust to Dust. My god, he never stops doing things! Oh, Atog. I was just wondering about you. Well, that means I take 12 damage and die. So I've lost yet another match with White Weenie. But, yeah. I feel like when I play White Weenie, I have no influence over anything. It's just up to my opponent. If I am the skill test. If they're good enough, they win. If they have a good enough draw, they win. If they don't, they lose. Alright, thanks for watching Magic Gathering Strat. I'm Dan. I lost.